Hey, buddies, and Victor, it's time for a Tainted Lilith run here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yes, we're going to be playing Tainted Lilith today because we had a special request for Lilith, and I figure, you know what? It's been a while, so why not play some Tainted Lilith? Yesterday's video did not cross 5,000 likes, so unfortunately the 5K streak did break, but that doesn't mean that the like streak counter is broken because we've got plenty of time for that one to reach over 5,000, get another one up towards the goal of 90 for the Espanol run. And again, thank you all very much for those of you who go out of your way to make it possible and support the channel by clicking the like button, leaving a comment. Seriously, it's the best way to support myself, and I do want to truly thank you all for those of you who go up and above and beyond just trying to go for the extra effort. Thank you all very much. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Circular Prism, artwork of the day. Title thread was somewhere in an alternate universe. Ah, yes. Little Blood Puppy or Sissy Puppy. There we go. Thank you very much to Circular Prism and all 42 of you who uploaded that one on the Sinvicta subreddit. Today is going to be Delta Delta 3 Quebec 707 Charlie. So we've got Tainted Lilith. She starts off with Jello and has a special animation attack, a whip attack that does a lot of damage. She's got a very powerful amount of synergies that Jello can perform. I mean, like, you know, Spirit Sword, of course, is one of the best ones. We've seen that on the channel before. And despite the horrifying animation that Lilith goes through every time you play Tainted Lilith, she's still one of the strongest, consistently one of the strongest characters in all of Repentance. And I think that, honestly, I won't sit up here and say that she's an instant win, but she definitely has some of the strongest starting potential anyway. Just based on the amount of damage that the whip does with Jello. And obviously, unlike the item Jello that Isaac can use, you know other iterations of Isaac anyway, this one you can constantly just spam over and over and over again. It still functions the same way that Jello does. As you see here, you don't have to spam the physical attack, the whip, and Jello still fires because obviously Isaac does not actually have any tears to speak about. So it's all done through the whip and all done through Jello's abilities as well. Wow, we just got 23 cents, or 22 cents rather, out of this. We could go into the curse room. I don't think it's worth it. These two soul hearts are gonna be very, very useful. That's the nice thing about Tainted Lilith to start off with, is that she just gets so, so powerful so quickly. It may have been worth it to check that playing card there, because that could have been two diamonds, but shoulda, coulda, woulda, but didn't. By God. So we get Infestation, which is going to give us some flies every time we take a hit from, doesn't matter what source. We also get the Stopwatch, which is going to slow down enemies, and the Battery, which is going to give us a double charge on our active item, which we don't currently have. The Stopwatch being half price, it's hard for me to pass that up just because, I mean, it's just so powerful. It brings all the speed of everything down to, you know, a crawl, and that's very good. When you don't have a whole lot of movement speed, or if you happen to have a little bit of a DPS problem. Of course, we don't have a DPS problem because we're playing as Tainted Lilith. I do wish that Jello could, like, tap buttons and stuff. That would be kind of nice, but that would also be a little bit broken. A triple bomb drop here, courtesy of that steel chest. I will use a bomb. Hopefully there's the secret room along with a key in here. There's not. Also, we also get prayer card, which honestly, prayer card is totally fine by me. Some early run HP is going to go a long way for us, especially if we end up going for devil deals. We're just getting bombs left and right, and I'm fine with that. Again, we have a curse room here. I'm not going to worry about it. We do finally get a Yave, so we will now go back to the golden chest here and hopefully get something good out of it. I mean, yeah, the backpack, if we end up getting something like magic skin or something, that would be nice to have. But obviously, by itself, the backpack does nothing. You need a second usable active item. But again, this is a good spot for it here early on. And we have a space bar item that is going to prove to be useful throughout the entire run. So we can give ourselves an HP upgrade right now. Definitely could use a tears up here. And again, some more damage would be nice. Jello does deal a portion of our damage as a physical hit. The Magic 8 Ball, which is going to give us a little bit of an increased Planetarium chance. And we get 9 Lies and Vengeful Spirit, which we can take both of these, no problem. So Vengeful Spirit, sure. Then Dead Cat's going to give us that. Seagram might be here. I thought it was over here. I still think it's over here. Yeah, you saw me try to fruitlessly and hopelessly try to knock that troll bomb that dropped there over to that spot, because that's where I originally thought it was, when turns out I was right. A Jawbreaker, which is also going to act kind of like Tough Love. See, here we're using the reach advantage, and I do mean literal reach advantage of Jello here. We're doing like proximity damage. And this kind of just illustrates that you don't need to use the whip attack as your primary source if you don't want to. If you have enough range and you have enough fire rate, like, Jello can very easily deal with anything that you come across with its ranged ability. You just have to, you know, get you're in many ways you're making yourself temporarily weaker, because obviously the damage from the physical hit is going to be front loaded into the animation instead of you having to wait for the shot to fire over and over and over again. But of course the trade-off being that, like, you know, you get to cause the damage without having to put Isaac inside of a precarious position. Really? Okay. Wow, I can't believe the secret room's not there. That looks like it's there for show. Maybe it is there for show. Because it just clearly wasn't there. Oh man, card reading. I love me some card reading. Everyone knows that Invicta loves him some card reading. If we could somehow make that work, man, that'd be the bee's knees. We may end up taking the chest in the boss room. Yeah, we do get 3 cents here. We don't have any more bombs, unfortunately. Petrified poop would be awesome. I didn't even see that fly until it was too late, fortunately. Okay, it's close. It's very close. 3 cents to pay dirt here for us getting card reading. The reason why I like card reading so much is basically just because it allows you to go straight to the boss, and then you can just decide for yourself whether or not you want to go any further than that. You can just nope on out of there if you have a powerful run going, and save yourself some time. Or, you know, you can backtrack. Normally, in normal circumstances, on any given floor, normally the boss room is going to be somewhat close to the shop and stuff, but usually further away from the item room. So it's sometimes counterintuitive to do that. But at the same time, if you're really powerful and you just want to blitz the game down for a win, you can easily do that with card reading. So I'm hoping that we end up getting it. We have stopwatch, so, you know, we have the ability to skip that room. Normally you'd have to wait and time it and stuff, but who's got that kind of time? Not me. Another thing that's nice about card reading is that if you have like half of a soul heart, like we do right now, you could use the card reading teleport to go to the boss, assuming you got a red portal, and that would allow you to basically guarantee the devil deal in case you get run into a room that has cheap damage, or, you know, you don't have enough movement speed to get away from mully booms, that sort of thing. All that stuff is completely nullified by you simply just going on into the, just walking into the red portal. There's no other way for us to get money, I don't think, here. We're going to have to lose this Eternal Heart, possibly, and the Soul Heart for sure. Yeah, there's no way for us to get those. Unless there's money inside of the Curse Room. You wouldn't be able to do that again if you tried. I have no idea how that didn't hit that chest. I'm just gonna... Yep. Okay, good. Alright! So we are not gonna get card reading after many different opportunities to do so. That is a shame. Two of clubs does not really help us. They've not been our super secret room. The super secret room was not anywhere here. So we're going to use the two of clubs, give ourselves two bombs, and we get two bombs back, so we still have a chance to find the super secret room, but the likelihood of it having money in there is very low. We're gonna have to once again re-enter into the curse room and now blow up this stone chest that should have been blown up in the first place. So notice how I used the brief little invincibility window there while the item hadn't registered in my inventory yet, and used that to put the damage on our red hearts instead of the fresh soul heart that we just got from Mom's Pearls. Super Seagram's gotta be there. And we'll head on down. That's funny, game. I'm looking to use some movement speed here. And I don't think Tractor Beam does anything for us in terms of what Jell-O can do, but it does help Jell-O's. I think it helps Jell-O's, yeah. It does put the tears right in front of Isaac. Which is that's a pretty big deal, because then essentially this turns into Isaac that has a minimum range, and that's it. Because like, if you look at it, it looks like Lilith is firing the tears now, and that's good. I mean, we want that direct damage. We don't want to have to rely on Jell-O and the range attack that he does. It's a shame that we had to lose that Eternal Heart for basically nothing. Hey, we did get a range upgrade for Mom's Pearls, so, and a Soul Heart, which may or may not secure our Devil Deal. Charge Key. We'll go ahead and use that now. Let's secure the HP upgrade. That's what we want. Down goes Gertie. Another tier's up here. Little Brimmy and Black Powder. Take a little Brimmy just to have a little bit of extra damage. So when we do actually fight with the tiers from Jell-O, we can complement that by having Little Brimmy fire off a Brimstone shot. Don't want to use our last card, our last bomb here. one more room clear and we can get ourselves a full charge. Wouldn't mind Dreamcatcher, to be honest. Okay. So I'm not going to use the prayer card yet because we're done with this floor. We can go into the curse room and then we can also go into the arcade. Guppy's paw is interesting. We've got school bag. Totally forgot about that. Let's go back out here and see what's in the boss trap room. The boss trap room is almost guaranteed to have something good in it. But we can only go in there when we have one heart or less. One red heart or less. So I just want to get to 15 cents. There's our second guppy item, by the way. Yeah, squeezy is very good. And all of a sudden, you can hear how much faster our attacks are, how frequent, I should say, our attacks are with Jell-O. And Big Horn just went right on top of the spikes. How does it feel, nerd? There we go, 15 cents. And I don't remember why we were trying to get 15 cents, but my brain is telling me that there was something in this shop that we wanted. Ah, yeah, Dreamcatcher. It's a Dreamcatcher. Don't want to dream no more. It's a Dreamcatcher. We're ready to go. Ready to go to the floor. Dreamcatcher's gonna give us... I forgot to use the prayer card. Anyway, Dreamcatcher's gonna give us a preview of what item is in our item room, despite there being Curse the Blind or not. And that looked like it was gonna be Mystery Sack. And, Mystery Sack and War, which is kind of disappointing. I think we're getting to the point now where, like, if we get a horseman, it's just a big bummer, you know? It just kind of just bums you out. It ruins the momentum that you had going for yourself. It was either War or is the Headless Horseman, but I'm pretty sure it's War because he was riding on the horse. And now we're getting to the point where we really need to start seeing some significant damage upgrades here. Despite us still being able to dispatch a lot of these enemies very easily, it's not going to get any easier without damage. This is where Little Brimmy is here to shine for us, making those big time plays. The room should be here. It's our only bomb, so it's kind of a risk to do that. And the damage that you have, the combined damage of Lil Brimmy and Jell-O is really good. We didn't have to pay a key to get in here, so I'm fine with that, because I would not have paid a key for Mystery Sack. But Mystery Sack keeps on showing up lately, and I mean, honestly, it can be a good item, I guess, but normally isn't. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it. It's okay. Let's put it this way. It's usually a non issue. It's a low impact, a very low impact item, because the results that you get from it are completely random and usually not good. Usually, I mean, they're beneficial most of the time, but they don't have a huge bearing on whatever you have going on in your run. That's what I mean by low impact. It was indeed war. I'm going to use a Wheel of Fortune card here just to... I mean, war is going to throw out bombs, so most likely he's going to destroy it for us. Come on, war. You can do it, buddy. Almost. Love to get that soul heart, but we would have to go over a spike rock. Really hoping that we do get a deal with the devil here that gives us Guppy. So we don't have to look for the store because, I mean, we don't have enough money to really do anything right now anyway. But we know that it's going to be a clean store because we've already fought greed on this floor. If we hurry, we can make boss rush. Let's check inside of the mom trap room real quick. Okay. Yeah, I think that let's cut our losses now on this floor. Hopefully we get a bomb so we can go into, so we can get the fool card and get out of boss rush. It's going to be a kind of a miracle if we can make it, but I'm going to try. It's unfortunate that Jello cannot get you these things. I think that maybe we might be able to finagle this nickel here. Super Magnet would do it though. Yeah, Super Magnet's gonna pull everything. You do have to be careful though, because Super Magnet does pull bombs and troll bombs to you, so yeah, you gotta be real careful. But that was a golden Super Magnet, and that was actually dropped by the mystery sack. So we do get a bomb here, but unless we're going in the right direction, we're probably not going to make boss rush, but we're still going to try. And you're kind of seeing how little damage we really do truly have here now. But no damage upgrades at all, and no, I don't count Blood Clot as a damage upgrade. I'm a little bit sad that runes aren't pulled by the by Super Magnet. Wow, we found the boss, but unfortunately we don't have a way of getting out of it. And boss rush is probably still not going to happen. If we had more damage, I would say the heck with the item room. But truth be told, I didn't even see what the item room was. I'm not even going to try to lie about that. I was not paying attention. We don't really need the soul heart, so I'm going to stop myself from getting it. Fight the urge to take the soul heart. Coupon is meh. Champion belt is not meh. Absolutely, take champion belt. We finally get a significant damage upgrade here. Of course, with champion belt, there comes its own challenges, because now we will most likely get champion mobs in every single room. But that's still a good thing, too, and that's something that some newer Isaac players probably don't realize, is that, you know, the more champions you get, the greater, yeah, it does increase the greater chance of death, because obviously you're fighting mobs that are way, way, way harder and tougher than their normal base counterparts. But you do get more consumable drops, and that can be pretty incredible. And that can also be kind of life-saving as well. Run-saving even. Hairpin's pretty good. Hairpin will give us a charge, a full charge on our spacebar item whenever we enter into a boss room. So that's pretty good for extra HP there. That was a rainbow champion. That's the reason why I couldn't get away from it. And we get the halo, halo. My little halo. Ah, dirt. Wait, no, it was soil, not dirt. Yeah, ah, dirt. That classic dirt song of Halo. When I first heard soil work, or heard of soil work, I was like, don't you mean those guys that sing My Little Halo? But then I realized that, oh, they're two completely different bands. I haven't heard like dirt in a while. I am going to hold on to Azazel's stump because let's try to rephrase that. I will. I will elect to take Azazel's. I will keep in my possession as my trinket Azazel's stump over the super magnet. Well, it's a little too late for the steam data. Okay. I'll take that. We probably didn't need that so hard, to be quite honest, because we've got plenty of HP, and we also have Guppy's paw, don't forget. Rabbit's fight, so our Guppy dream is still kind of dead right now. I wouldn't mind holding on to the head of Krampus over Guppy's paw. We don't really need to use Guppy's paw either, to be quite honest. You know, the head of Krampus is going to be nice to help us clear some early stuff in like the womb and that sort of thing. I know the womb isn't like early game, but still, like, you know, the more annoying rooms here with only a three room cooldown. And on top of that, remember, we have the battery. So we're going to be able to really we're going to be able to accumulate those charges and then use just back to back Krampus heads. And that's very, very strong for dishing out some premium pain on the paltry causing plentiful enemies. Small rock is going to give us a damage up and a tears up as well, but a movement speed down, which is okay because that's a small price to pay for, you know, not having a good damage rating up until this point, up until us getting champion belt, essentially. Ever since champion belt kicked in, we got Halo and we got small rock as well. I'm gonna stop using the prayer card for now. To the point where I don't think red hearts are going to matter. We'll get Jesus Juice another damage upgrade. Four straight damage upgrades now. Make that five. And I will take the nail. I'll take the nail over the prayer card. We've gotten what we needed out of the prayer card, so yeah. Five straight damage upgrades. Oh baby. Caught me a little off guard there, not gonna lie. I Down goes Wrath, and don't really need to get into the boss trap room, so I'm just not gonna. But notice how Azazel Stump does cause Jello to also fire that little mini brimstone, proximity brimstone. But whenever it's charging, it does revert. His position reverts back to wherever Lilith is. Now this room can just go frick itself. And use the nail here just to give us some Devil Deal protection. We don't really have the keys to do this, but the potential payoff is possibly worth it. It wasn't. So hard back. Good, good. All right now. I'm gonna put the mini charge on the nail. Still have flying, so we can take this. Death card, chariot card. I take the chariot card, even though it's not that great. This is where this room right here, that's where flying is a Viking. Again, Mom's Heart tries to spawn one underneath us. This time we were able to dodge it, unlike yesterday's. That's right. You think I forget that kind of stuff, game? I don't. I forget a lot of things, but that kind of stuff, your boy doesn't forget. I have Belial or the Quarter. Neither one of them really tickling my fancy, and unfortunately, no Guppy. So no surprise here that Isaac is our boss in the cathedral. So what a little Tywin there. I don't know how I did that. Tywin Lannister. You know, say what you want about Game of Thrones. Like, everyone knows I've been very adamant about not liking the way that it finished. In fact, I went so far, and I still stand by this, that season 8, the ending completely ruined the entire show. Knowing where it goes, it's really impossible to watch Game of Thrones again. But still, my favorite character, I think, honestly, is Tywin Lannister. I know that he's a bad guy, and I don't normally gravitate towards the villains, but I really I'm a big fan of Charles Dance. I was super happy that he was in a Godzilla film, like a true blue Godzilla film. And that's so cool, because he's easily like the biggest name in those movies. And the fact that he played like, you know, a bad character, he basically played Tywin Lannister, but in a Godzilla film. And that's just awesome. But in the Game of Thrones series, like, Tywin really is my favorite character, I think. Just because, like, you know, he's... I don't know. There's something about the way that Charles Dance plays him. And the acting and just the character is very interesting. Sort of the last vestige of the old world, you know, old traditions and that sort of thing. And I don't know. Just commands respect. Maybe that's the reason why I like him. Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, if you haven't seen Game of Thrones, it's definitely worth watching. But I don't personally I don't personally think that like it's all that great anymore. I would have said it would have been an instant recommendation up until season 8. And I know that some people are like, well, you shouldn't let it, by the way, full clear. You shouldn't let the bad ending, like, sort of like, you know, or objectively bad ending. You shouldn't let that sully the entire series, blah, blah, blah. But it's like, yeah, but like, it still does for me anyway. It's the same reason why I don't like prequels, like prequel shows and prequel movies and stuff. Like, as soon as I know where the destination is, I check out. Like, I'm gone. Like, my immersion is over. You know, the only exceptions, I would say, that I didn't mind them, that the fact that I was watching a prequel, and some people aren't going to like this, and that's fine. I like Phantom Menace. I don't mind the Clone Wars and Revenge of the Sith. You know, I'm like, yeah, that's their Star Wars. But I'm also a huge Star Wars fan, too, though. So that also is a little bit biased. But like origin stories and like and those, like, I mean, Batman Begins, yeah, it was a great movie. Don't get me wrong, it was definitely probably one of the best modern Batman movies ever, other than Dark Knight. But like, I already know it's cool to see where something begins. So like, I guess in a way, origin stories, I'm better with origin stories. I'm more accepting of origin stories than I am of prequels. Prequels annoy me because it's like, oh, all this mystery, like, oh, you know, like it's something that Better Call Saul kind of does. You know, it's like, yeah, I love Better Call Saul, and I think it's actually better than Breaking Bad in many ways. But like, if Bob Odenkirk's character is ever in danger, it's like, okay, well, we already know he doesn't die, or like, we already know that this character doesn't die. Like, come on, man, there's no mystery. I don't know, that's just me. Maybe I'm a movie ignoramus. A movie critic I am not. Fucking back blood rights, by the way. We have no real way of actually, like, you know, reloading you, but hey, it's good to have you. We can actually go down to no HP here. Hey, there we go. Okay, alright now. Gimpy helping us out quite a bit. I don't mind using soul hearts there because we have plenty of them down here. Plus, blood rites triggering a black heart is a ton of damage, and we're just going to go right to the boss, I guess. Sure. Fine with me. So, anyway, thank you all very much for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button, even though it kind of doesn't really matter anymore. And subscribe if you're not here part of the Mosh Pit. I do appreciate everyone who does. We're almost at 300,000 subs, which honestly is just ridiculous. Like, that number to me it's not even like a real number anymore. Like, it's just, it's a dream come true. So I hope you all had a great start to your weekend, everyone. I hope to see you on the Twitch stream, twitch.tv/Invicta. And those of you who are members of the Patreon Mosh Pit, keep an eye out. We've got something very cool dropping for you very, very soon. So thank you again for watching. Have a great Saturday, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Drawl, Candy Duder, Elira Violi, Ethan Hanley, and Tyler Sears. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.